Untap your full potential with the Untapped Deck Tracker. Both the in-game overlay and the personal stats provide a lot of value. Download it for free today using the link below, and you'll be supporting the channel at the same time. Hello and welcome to my first Alchemy video. Today we're gonna ease into the format with a red-green Werewolves deck that features a few new cards from Alchemy, as well as some cards from Crimson Vow that I haven't had the chance to feature yet. At 1 mana we kick things off with Tenacious Pup, a 1-2 wolf that when it enters a battlefield gains 1 life, and when we cast our next creature spell, that creature enters a battlefield with an additional +1/+1 counter, trample counter, and a vigilance counter on it, and that will curve very nicely into a turn 2 Rahilda, Wanted Cutthroat, a 2-mana 2-2 legendary human werewolf with first strike, and when Rahilda deals combat damage to a player, we exile a non-land card from their library at random, and during any turn we attacked with a wolf or werewolf, we can cast that card and we may spend mana as though it were mana of any color to cast that spell. That's the Daybound side, and once it transforms to night, we get Rahilda, Feral Outlaw, a 2-2 with a double strike and that same ability, so it can potentially exile multiple cards at once. Then at 1 mana we also have Ascendant Packleader from Crimson Vow, a 2-1 that enters the battlefield with a +1/+1 counter on it if we control a permanent with mana value 4 or greater, and whenever we cast a spell with mana value 4 or greater, we also get to put a +1/+1 counter on the Packleader. And all these 1-drops are very important for Packsong Pup from Crimson Vow, a 1-1 wolf saying at the beginning of combat on our turn, if we control another wolf or werewolf, put a +1/+1 counter on the pup, and when it dies we also gain life equal to its power. So having those 1-drops guarantees that the Packsong Pup starts picking up +1 counters as early as turn 2. Then we also have the Werewolf Pack Leader, a 3-3 with pack tactics allowing us to draw a card, and we have an activated ability for 4 mana turning it into a 5-3 trampler. Then we have Gassig Naturalist, a 2-2 human werewolf that when it attacks adds red or green to our mana pool, and until end of turn we don't lose this mana as steps and phases end. And then at night it turns into Lord of the Ulvenwald, a 3-3 giving other wolves and werewolves we control +1/+1, and has that same mana ability, which will also help us play these additional 1-drops out in our second main phase. Then at 3 mana, one of our most important creatures is Tovalar, Dire Overlord, a 3-3 legendary human werewolf, saying whenever a wolf or werewolf we control deals combat damage to a player, we get to draw a card. That also makes our 1-drops even more powerful. And then at the beginning of our upkeep, if we control 3 or more wolves and or werewolves, it becomes night, and then we transform any number of human werewolves we control. So an excellent way to turn it to night without having to pass a turn without casting anything. And then at night turns into Tovalar, the Midnight Scourge, a 4-4 with the same card draw ability, and a nice pump ability as well for X, a red and a green, target wolf or werewolf we control gets +X+0, and gains trample until end of turn. Then we've got Reckless Stormseeker, a 2-3 human werewolf, saying at the beginning of combat on our turn, target creature we control gets +1/+0 and gains haste until end of turn, so curving a pack leader into a turn 3 Stormseeker allows us to attack for 6 and enable pack tactics right away. And then at night it turns into Stormcharge Slasher, a 3-4 giving a creature +2/+0, trample and haste until end of turn instead. Then at 4 mana we've got our Planeswalker, Arlin, the Pack's Hope, starts out at 4 loyalty, and on the Daybound side can minus 3 to create a pair of 2-2 Green Wolf creature tokens, then the +1 says until our next turn we can cast creature spells as though they had flash, and they enter with an additional +1/+1 counter on it, so a great way to pass the turn and be able to transform to night and still cast your creatures in the opponent's turn. And then at night she transforms into Arlin, the Moon's Fury, which can add red and green to her mana pool with the +2, or can turn into a 5-5 werewolf creature with trample, indestructible, and haste, which is probably the mode we're going to use most often, because this is a much lower curve version than some other werewolf decks I've featured in the past that maybe play the 6-mana Caretaker or Huntmaster. Instead here we're topping off with Volatile Arsonist, a 5-mana 4-4 human werewolf with menace and haste, and when the Arsonist attacks, it deals 1 damage to each of up to 1 target creature, up to 1 target player, and or up to 1 target planeswalker, and then at night transforms into Dire Strain Anarchist, a 5-5 with menace and haste, and has that same damage ability but now deals 2 damage instead. So very powerful if we can transform to night, which is why Tovalar and Arlin are so important. Then our mana base is skewed heavily towards green to support a turn 2 pack leader, and we also have 2 copies of Lair of the Hydra as a nice creature land, then 9 basic forest, 5 basic mountains, and some dual lands with the Pathway and Rockfall Vale. Now, as you may have noticed, we're not really playing any removal spells in the main deck outside of the Arsonist ability. We don't have an easy way to destroy opposing creatures, but this deck is much more about amassing a lot of power and toughness, curving out and then refueling with Tovalar's ability, and the Packleader can also draw additional cards. So it's a much more aggressive and linear build, as opposed to some other versions of Werewolves that maybe had some more expensive cards and were aimed more towards the late game. And then, as you may have noticed, we also don't have any copies of Ranger class at 2 mana, which is another one of those cards that shines in more controlling matchups, where we can eventually get it to level 3 to start casting creatures over the top. Howling Moon is another one of those cards that can help us progress our game plan without overextending into a sweeper, so those are definitely cards I would have in the sideboard for those more controlling matchups. But for now, we're going to see how this more aggressive strategy plays out, especially focusing on these 1-drops in combination with turn 2 Packsong Pup and Rahilda, which can also provide extra card advantage. So yeah, that's our deck. Now let's jump in some games and see how the deck does. Alright, we're on the draw, missing some 2 and 3 drops, but I think we'll still try it. Opponents on a white life gain deck. And then ideally we pick up a powerful 2-drop so we can give it an extra counter, trample and vigilance. Alright, Packsong Pup's perfect. So it's gonna grow up to a 3-3 right away. Never mind, Fateful Absence to destroy it. And hit for 1. Fibblethup is a little bit disoriented here. The Celestis. Okay, so we can crack a clue and then probably play Packleader, which next turn will also pick up an extra counter from Arlin. So not the best start imaginable, but at least we're on the board. Faceless Haven now turns into a 3-3 as opposed to a 4-3. So a small nerf. Celebrants gains a life. And we'll make some tokens here with Arlin.
I can feel the yearning of the wild grow more intense.
Right, another absence kills Arlin, but good thing we have a backup. And we can get in 1 damage. Cleric class all the way to level 2. So your opponent gets a plus 1 counter, which does mean that the Celebrant turns into a powerful blocker. But it is night, so any werewolves we might draw are going to be quite scary, Arlin included. So let's play Arlin, and then I'm tempted not to play the Packleader to keep it nighttime. So I could attack with everyone, lose a wolf, but deal quite a bit of damage in the process. I think that's acceptable. So if I play Packleader, I had a 3-2 to the board, but it's going to switch back to daytime. Celestis is going to loot again. I think we keep it night. Ooh, with a Book of Exalted Deeds to combo with Faceless Haven. So it's going to take quite a bit of mana for them to activate both, but they're getting there. Alright, so this is going to be daytime anyways. And an extra plus 1 counter from Cleric class. Not the best draw so far. So I'll crack a clue and see what we get. A naturalist, so probably going to plus with Arlin. Let it switch to knight again, even though that means our opponent gets to loot with the Celestis. and then kind of flash in some werewolves and try and go wide. Our deck does struggle to deal with large creatures, but that's true in general for red-green. Sigarda's Plunder, sure. Ooh, Tovalar was an excellent draw. So Arlen can turn into Wolf. Play Tovalar, which can also pump one of our creatures and smash with a team. So I can pump for three here. So now we have to decide if we want to keep our mana to potentially cast whatever we draw with Tovalar, or we can try and pump one of our creatures to get in more damage. Now if we cast another spell, it will switch back to daytime, so that's mainly a concern because of the Celestus, because then in our turn it's going to go back to night thanks to Tovalar. Although it looks like we actually have lethal here, since I forgot to count Arlen's damage, and good thing we did, because next turn our opponent would have been able to set up their combo. Alright, we're on the play, and missing a red mana mainly. Can play turn one pack leader, don't have a 2-drop. Yeah, this curve seems a little bit too high, and we could run into some mana problems. This seems better, much better. Get rid of the Arsonist, and then we can curve Tenacious Pup into turn to Rahilda. It's going to be a 3-3 first strike, trample, and vigilance. And then a turn 3 Tovalar. Opponent with an Epicure, some sort of vampire deck. Could even play turn 2 Packleader as a 4-4. So giving Rahilda Trample means they wouldn't be able to chum block with Epicure to prevent the ability, but there is the potential concern of a 3 damage burn spell, so maybe Packleader is a safer investment here. Alright, I guess I can buy that. Even though it would be nice to see the new cards in action. Alright, Tovalar could be the play here. And then we can smash with a team, hopefully draw some cards. Opponent's gonna chump. We could see the new 3 damage sweeper for triple red next turn, but that's still not enough to kill our pack leader, so another reason to get it up to an extra point of toughness. But opponent's blue reds. Could see a bounce spell on the pack leader as well. Hopefully draw a land so we can double spell next turn, as Divide by Zero bounces pack leader main phase to keep it daytime. And we did find a land. So I can double spell, could go for Pack Song Pup plus Rahilda, or maybe Pack Song Pup plus pack leader. Starting to grow the Pack Song Pup seems important, so I think that's a priority. And then do I want the extra power and toughness? I think I do. Could have waited on playing the pack leader, see what we draw off Tovalar first, but didn't think that was gonna change our play significantly. Alright, so opponent's pretty far behind on board. They might have a sweeper at 5 mana to catch up. Just an environmental sciences for now. Luckily we do have a creature land as well to keep up the pressure. And we're about to draw a lot of cards. Switches to knights. Thanks to Tovalar, and our opponent has seen enough. I guess the fact that we had a Tovalar could have been a reason to still play Rahilda, since a double striking werewolf would have been nice. But yeah, on to the next one. Alright, we're on the play with a keepable hand. So if we want to play turn two Packleader, I should probably kick things off with a tapped Rockfall Veil. Could get punished if we draw another Lair of the Hydra, which was the reason to play Lair, but then I would not have been able to play Packleader on two, which I think is still the plan here. If we had a one drop in play, then Paxung Pup would have been a little bit more tempting, as it would have picked up a counter right away. Alright, Portable Hole. Good answer to the Packleader. So, I think to be mana efficient, we still play Tovalar, especially since we have a backup. And then hopefully we can start connecting and drawing cards. Witness the Future. Interesting. That's not a new Alchemy card, just kind of a weird card from Crimson Vow. Either way, I can play the Paxung Pup now, and then attack. And hopefully draw another cheap creature. We did not. So it's not gonna transform to Knight just yet. And a Key to the Archive, powerful new Alchemy card that can draft a card from the spellbook, so our opponent will get three cards to choose from out of this list, and then a four mana artifact that makes two mana, so I'm pretty scared. Now I could play Arsonist, or we could keep it as a way to potentially recover from a sweeper effect. Opponent also has to discard here, got rid of a Memory Deluge. Alright, Reckless Stormseeker gives us another nice tool to recover from sweepers, or we could play it now and then keep Arsonist for next turn. It's a close call. I think I'm liking Arsonist now and then Stormseeker plus another 3-drop next turn to be more mana efficient and get more damage in. And then I can potentially like play Tovalar plus Stormseeker. So we get to draw three. So that's not too bad. Let's see if there's a sweeper. Teferi, who slows down time, can untap the Key to the Archive, so that's a cool synergy. Almost pays for itself. Opponent back up to 8, and a Time Warp, wow, to take an extra turn. Yeah, that's a pretty good card to be able to draft with Key to the Archive. Of course, you're not guaranteed to get a Time Warp, but that's probably the best card our opponent could have gotten here. Flashback Memory Deluge, so they're looking for a sweeper or some interaction, and they'll have a bunch of mana left to potentially cast it. Their opponent still has 4 mana to work with. If they don't bounce any of my werewolves, it will transform to Knight, which is probably something the opponent wants to avoid. Alright, transforms to Knight. And yeah, I guess we'll add more to the board here. Can go for a Stormseeker. And then could also play Packleader to give the Packleader haste instead of the Stormseeker, or Stormseeker can target itself and then I can use Tovalar for an extra point of damage perhaps. Alright, looks like Stormseeker is gonna get the job done here. On to the next one. Alright, we're on the play with a nice hand. Packleader into probably turn to Paxung Pup, since that will pick up a counter right away. Although, I do want to see Rahilda in action as well. Opponent black-white. And then next turn Tovalar with a 1-2 start can draw us two cards right away. opponent a black-white life gain deck, double veteran, that's fine. So that does do a decent job of blocking Ascendant Packleader. So I could go for Stormseeker instead of Tovalar, and then maybe next turn play Tovalar. And then we can give Tovalar haste as well. I think that's reasonable. And then probably go for red, in case we need double red for Arsonist at some point. Alright, hopefully dodge a Voice of the Blessed. Alright, there's a Voice of the Blessed. Could have been a reason to still attack with Packleader to keep the opponent's voice at a 3-3. But there's Arsonist, not bad. So, can play Tovalar, give Tovalar the extra point of power, and then attack Paxung Pup Tovalar. And then potentially draw two. Although, if we trade away Tovalar, it's not going to transform to Knight next turn, but if we can trade for Voice of the Blessed, I think I'm happy. So, yeah, this looks fine. Opponent takes it. So now it's going to transform to Knight next turn if Tovalar survives. And hopefully we get to play a 5-mana Arsonist dealing 2 damage. Alright, Skyclave Apparition is going to prevent that from happening. Voice now a 6-6. Okay, can still play Arsonists, can kill a veteran, and then I can pump the Paxung Pup so it's big enough to attack past Voice of the Blessed. Or I can go Tovalar plus Rahilda. That doesn't seem as good to me. And then the question is if the Ascendant Packleader also wants to attack. Because their opponents might be double blocking Arsonist with Voice and one of the remaining 1/1s or Apparition. It's a close call. I don't think Stormseeker wants to attack. What happens if I attack with everyone? Opponent goes Chump Paxung Pup. Then they can eat Stormseeker. And then they can trade for Packleader. Yeah, that doesn't seem amazing. Packleader will pick up a counter from Arlen as well. So it might be just these two. Alright, take out Apparition. Opponent's at 2. And another veteran. And a Righteous Valkyrie. Good draw. Opponent's still at 5, and next turn we're gonna die to that Voice of the Blessed. So what's the best I can do here? Can animate my Lair of the Hydra, which would be a 4-4. And then opponent has 4 blockers. It's going to be difficult to actually kill them. There's no reach creatures I can draw. What if I make a hasty Rahilda? And then I can still send in a small Lair of the Hydra. I guess that's the play. but our opponent should be able to survive at one life. Although I guess if the Paxong Pup dies, I also gain 6. So we'll see if our opponent notices that interaction. So I'm at 11, but I guess we're still 1 point short of surviving. And our opponent could also grow the voice even more with Righteous Valkyrie here anyway. Alright, so very close game. I wonder if I should have attacked with a pack leader the turn before. Very much possible. But it also highlights one of the weaknesses of red-green not being able to deal with large creatures. On to the next one. Alright, we're on the draw with a keepable hand for sure. Tenacious Pup into... We can choose between Pack Song or Pack Leader, but if we go Pack Leader, we'll have Pack Tactics on turn 3, so that's tempting. Facing red-white dragons with a new Fearsome Whelp. And yeah, it's time for Pack Leader, I think. Now it does still potentially die to a Dragon's Fire if they have a 4-power dragon in hand. But that's a risk I'm willing to take. It's going to be a Fateful Absence instead. So this turn, Stormseeker, next turn, double Paxong Pup, as the Fearsome Whelp discounts their dragons. So let's see some big dragons. And Dragon's Fire kills Stormseeker. Alright. And another Fearsome Whelp. Okay. So, opponent can play their dragons almost for free at this point. I think it's just double Paxong Pup here. Alright, there's a Moonveil Regent for 1 mana. And their last card, another Dragon's Fire, which will let them draw with a Regent, so... We're in a bit of trouble. Moonveil Regent, very good last card to have, as it will keep drawing more and more. Pack Leader, so Pack Leader plus Pup. And then next turn I can also activate the Pack Leader to maybe attack past a 4-4. Adult Gold Dragon's gonna make it hard to race. Opponent's happy with the card in their hands, even though they could have drawn 2. But at 18 life I don't see us killing our opponent here. So even if I pump Pack Leader, I would have 13, so not quite. Is there anything I can hope to draw that gets me out of it? I don't think so, even if I cracked a clue beforehand. So yeah, seems like we're dead. But let's see what we draw off Pack Leader, I suppose. Still a close game. Would have been winnable without that 4 life gain from the Adult Gold Dragon. And they had another Adult Gold Dragon in hand, which is why they didn't want to loot last turn. Alright. Yeah, for 2 mana, that card's quite powerful. On to the next one. Alright, we're on the play with a nice hand. Packleader into Rahilda. And we've got a good mana base. Let's see what we're up against. Another green deck. Tenacious Pup would also be a nice combo with Rahilda. If our opponent has the 3-3 Packleader next turn, I might want to wait and make sure it's a little bit bigger. So I can buy the line of Packleader into Tenacious Pup, and then next turn Rahilda will pick up that extra counter. It's going to be an Outland Liberator instead. So I'm okay trading Packleader here. And then hopefully Rahilda can get in some damage. Could also see a Blizzard Brawl. Alright, never mind. Rahilda, too powerful. Yeah, if you can block Rahilda profitably early on, it's an incredibly demoralizing card to face. On to the next one. Alright, we're on the play with a fine hand except for the lack of red mana. Can play Pup into Packleader, but that's kind of where things end. If we draw a red source off the top, then Pup into Naturalists could set up some very explosive plays. But we're on the play, so we're not incredibly likely to find that red source right away. And then I think we're better off mulliganing. Alright, I guess I'll keep this. And then we've got Pup into Packleader, still need that red mana. But now we can potentially wait a turn on it. Alright, there we go, perfect. So this is one of the better curve out starts our deck is capable of. Both Tovalar and Stormseeker are excellent plays here. But Stormseeker makes a little bit more sense, as that will set up more hasty creatures in the future. Opponent on some sort of green-white humans deck. Now we do have to keep that new sweeper in mind at 4 mana, so that's certainly a card our opponent could be playing, and that's one of the better catch-up mechanisms. Now I guess if we play Tovalar we do get to draw 4 cards, so that's nice. Plus we get a lot of damage in, so it might still be worth it. Could also go with Hasty Rahilda and then exile a card from the opponent's library. I guess Tovalar is still maybe worth it here. So I'll wait on playing the land in case I want to play a tapped Lair of the Hydra. So we get to draw 5 cards total once we account for the pack tactics. So should be able to refuel and recover from a sweeper next turn. Alright, so I'm gonna hang on to Ascendant Packleader since we should have enough pressure in play as is. So if they wipe the board, we should be fine. Alright, it's going to be a key to the archive instead. Didn't think that's going to be enough, and our opponent concedes. Alright, so good to see quite a few new alchemy cards in action here. Lots of fast games, people trying new stuff, so that's exciting. And overall, Red-Green Werewolves has some issues, like we saw against Voice of the Blessed. So it could be a reason to still try and sneak in some removal spell. Maybe the new fight spell from Alchemy could be worth it. And then as I mentioned in the introduction, there's plenty of sideboard options for more controlling matchups as well. So definitely a lot of ways to build werewolves nowadays, but I'm definitely liking the new additions of Tenacious Pup into those powerful 2-drops. So that's going to do it for today's gameplay. Want to thank you for watching, hope you enjoyed, and as always, have a nice day. I also want to thank all my patrons for being part of the channel, and you can become a patron yourself today and decide the topic of future videos over at patreon.com/legendvd.